A lot of people have asked me what is the simplest way of making art in Photoshop, but what I did tell them is that there is no one simple way of making art in Photoshop, but you just have to go online, check on the arts that thrill you the most, then you try to figure out how it's been done, then you get started on that part and practice more, then you will be able to get a nice art style. But anyway, someone just asked me that today, so I just take out some time and I go on Instagram and I just do some search, and I find an artist. Well, she's a girl, and practically when I look at her works, they are really really awesome, and you know, there's something tricky about the work which I really have to show you guys, and then I'm really going to break it down for you guys so that you get to make use of that method for yours as a beginner. But there are things you need to consider before making use of that art style. So first, let's get into Instagram or open up your Chrome or whatever browser you are making use of. So I'm gonna open up my Chrome and I'll just go into Instagram. All right, so here in Instagram, what I'm just going to do, I'm just going to type art by Debbie. Let's see. Okay, so the first one right here, which is this, so that's her right there. This is kind of like zoomed out a little bit, so I'm just going to zoom this in. Yeah, so let's set this back to 100%. All right, that's awesome. So here it is. So now take a look at her art. It's kind of like outstanding. It's really really looking nice, unlike regular paintings and so on in Photoshop. You can see how it looks like. It's really really cool. Like, for the very first time when I set my eyes on this art, it's really really amazing and it's pretty cool. But coming down to this part of this art, and this is kind of like a clean drawing right inside of Photoshop. If you get to look this or whatever program she is using, I really don't know. Maybe I can get to talk to her and get some details from her, and then I can make another video about that and post to you guys. But there is something I really wanted to show you guys. So when you look up closely to all these artworks, you can see that there is nothing really really going on, like painting and so on. Hold on, let's keep scrolling down. There is one in particular I really need to show you. Okay, let's get into this. So look at this. Now when you look at the cloth, there is something really really tricky about the cloth. It's unlike the real painting which we all created in Photoshop. So when you look at the cap or hat or whatever it is, I really don't know what this is called. When you look at, you can see that we have some things like the oil painting effect and what so on. Now, if you guys have watched most of my videos, like most of the caricatures which I have made in Photoshop, you get to see some kind of effects that I have used on all this part. So we'll come down to this one here. Like, if I get to go close to this one, look, we have something like color pop right here. We have some kind of filters right here and a stroke, then some other highlights to really really make it look nice. But anyway, I'm just gonna get, okay, so I'm gonna get this one, I'm gonna save this, and I'm just gonna save this on my desktop. That's an HTML, right? Cancel. So what I'm going to do right here to get this, let's see if I can download this with this part and I still get an HTML. Well, I really don't know, so let's check from here. And yeah, I just really can't save it. So we just have to do everything right here, but I really need to take this art into Photoshop. Well, this is an HTML file, so I won't be able to do that. But anyway, let's keep going. Maybe I'm just going to zoom in closely for you guys to see. Okay, so when you look at this art very well, it's okay. Now this is a real image. Exactly, this is just a real image. As I'm looking at this thing, if I try to break down this effect that she used on this image, I might be wrong, but I want you guys to give it a try and it's really going to work out for you guys. I certainly know that. And I'm going to make another video on how to make this art style, something like this. Okay, so now when you look closely to the image, this is a real image. Now there's something I really want to show you guys. Look at the pants. You can see that it's we're having the oil painting effect on these pants, right? And now, so okay, let's take the basic process that if I want to make an art like this, how I will go about making this art. This is it. So I'll start off removing the background from this art, and after removing the background, right, I'll make use of the Nick collection, the HGR like, which I've already showed you guys in one of my videos, which is how I smudge in Photoshop. Make use of the HDR like, and then I will go ahead and I will smudge. And after smudging, right at this point, I'll add up some vibrance to it. Then I can make use of the dodge and burn to bring out all those lighter part of the skin, which you can see right now. Then once I'm done with that, I'm just going to make a rough strokes around the subject, just exactly what you are seeing. And finally, I'm going to apply an oil painting filter that will give me the kind of painterly look which you guys are seeing right now. Then after everything, I can add up some color pop, boost the vibrance, boost the color. You can make use of the camera raw, or you can make use of the vibrance, or maybe add more saturation to this. It all really depends on how you want to make use of it. And add up a digital background that is really, really going to look awesome. Now let me really show you one other thing I found that here. So let's keep going. There is one I really find out which I just said. Okay, so here we go. Let's take a look at this. Now look at this color. Now when you apply the HDR like Nick collection on this image, on your image or whatever image you are making use of, your cloth is really going to be like, it's going to be something like a little bit worn out or a little bit old. But most times, most people make use of the Color FX Pro. It's kind of like, because after updating to the latest version of Nick collection, I really don't see that Color FX Pro. So you can go back in Photoshop and back in Nick collection, then you can get those stuff. So looking at this, and you can see that this is totally showing us that it's a real image, because it's kind of like this was when she was just starting up making her arts, making all these kind of arts. And it's really, 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 you know, when you're just starting up, your art is not really going to be that awesome, and now you just have to start learning, see, get better in what you do. So we have something like this, and when you look at, you can see that there is no communication between the word, the subject, and the background, which is kind of like a fantasy. But that doesn't really matter, as long as that looks good and the client really loves it. That's what that matter most. Doesn't really matter on how you get to do that. So let's quickly check on other ones and see the ones which we can quickly break down. All right, so here we go. We have this one right here. Now this is a clean example of making use of a Nick collection, or the Color FX Pro in the Nick collection. Now when you look closely to the hair, you can see that we have some stroke, some random strokes trying to show us that the hair, it's a little bit of something, the paint or so on. Now in, there's one other of my video when I show you guys how to add strokes to the hair. I guess that is where I turn a pencil, a portrait into a pencil sketch. I guess I'm gonna leave the link in the description to that for you to check that. Then I add up the strokes and use some kind of filters which make turn the picture into a black and white, and finally gives me a nice pencil sketch effect. So something like this is going on here. So right here, now we are having the smudge, the Nick collection, the brush, and just a vibrance, and adding up a nice background that is really, really going to make it pop and make it look more like arts and so on. Now you can check her and make sure to follow her, and that's, so let's take a look at this and make sure to follow her, and you can get inspired with her art as she keep posting and so on. So if you really don't have that time drawing or, you know, painting, you can just make use of this method and you can keep going. So this is just exactly almost all her art are just exactly the way it is, but she's doing it in a kind of a different way, which It's really, really awesome. Now, there is one thing you need to know. Like I said, there is something you need to understand, which you need to know. First thing that you need to know, you need to have a high definition picture. If you're working with a low quality image that is not really making any sense, this effect is not really going to work perfectly. You just have to try and have a nice look. When you see most of her pictures, you are having a close-up shot that it's really, really making sense. Like here now, this is kind of like a shot coming out from the camera, which is exactly what we are seeing here at this point. So you just need to make use of a close-up shot, and you need to understand the method of dodge and burning. I guess I still have that story in my channel, and a little bit of refining skills. You really, really need that, a little bit of refining skills, so that you will be able to add up a nice finishing touch to your artworks to really make it look like hers. And at this point, I guess she go extreme in this one. Now you can see the dodge and the burning. You can see this part really, really light and a skin tone kind of light, adding some kind of effects and so on. Yeah, there are so many things you can use to achieve this effect, but the main ones which you are going to use, and before using those effects, what you really, really need is you need a high definition picture, and you know, system that can give the oil painting filter. If your system is a little bit outdated, you can go back to Photoshop CS6 or maybe lower, and that's really, 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 really help you. So you can just check her out, and I'm going to leave a link in the description to her Instagram handle, like that will be very, very easy for you guys to check. Now the one thing that makes her art to pop very well is her background. The background is really, really amazing. Like, it adds more color to the background and really make it look nice. Like, when you see something, most of her artwork with the green background, it's really, really amazing, which is just what you are seeing right now. And this can save a whole lot of time. Like, you can work on 2, 3, 4 art a day. It doesn't really matter, as long as you have time. You can work on all this kind of artwork can take you probably 2-3 hours, depending on how fast you are. And you need to know that it will be very, very good to have a digital tablet. But if you don't, it's fine. I can advise you, give you some other tips which you can make use of. So if you don't have a digital tablet, what you have to do to make this line, so after making the effect on the artwork, moving the background and making the effect on the image, now the next thing you need to do, you need to import this image into Adobe Illustrator, and you create a brush, then make use of the pen tool to trace and apply that brush. Maybe you can create a rough brush or whatever kind of brush you want to create in Adobe Illustrator, then you can use that. But if you have a digital tablet, it will be really, really easy. You have to do everything right inside of Photoshop. So I hope this tip really helped you guys, and if you do, leave your comment in the comment box to see what you've done or what you gained from this video. And don't forget to check her out, make sure to hit that follow button on her Instagram page, so that when she posts a new artwork, you get notified or you get to see it whenever she posts a new artwork. So that brings us to the end of this video, and if you do like the video, make sure to hit the subscribe button, not just the subscribe button, ring the bell icon, so that you don't miss any new Photoshop or digital arts tutorial coming up every week in my channel. See you guys in the next video. Do have a nice day.